Welcome to the PeopleSoft Campus Solutions PUM Image 35 Highlights. In this video, we'll provide an overview to the key features delivered as part of PUM Image 35. We'll cover updates to SEVIS, UK regulatory updates for both UCAS and HESA, US financial aid updates for aid year 2025-2026, the new configurable course catalogue numbering setup, Edu-API REST services, and the student financial planning enhancements. US SEVIS Updates. For Phase 2 of the updates to support the SEVIS 6.80 batch release, we have made some additional updates. For biographical alerts generated by process SEVIS alerts, the logic to trigger the alert based on changes to an exchange visitor's preferred phone number has been updated to consider international phone numbers. Validation is added to the process to report an error if the exchange visitor does not have a preferred phone number. For both students FM and exchange visitors J, there are a number of updates to the additional data page in Select Alerts to Report to reflect changes to the data required for some alerts in Release 6.80. For example, for authorized to drop below full course alerts, validation is added that the remarks field must be populated. Similar updates are made to the History Detail page in View SEVIS Events History for both students and exchange visitors. UK regulatory updates. For HESA, we have modified the Create Extract process to support the first phase of Register API that replaces HESA ITT return for 2025-26. Updated values of HESA fields, entity fields, and returns setup. Updated the ITT extract data page to Register Extract data page. And added new fields, page, service operations, documents, document schemas, and export trainee process for the Register API. For UCAS, we have modified the import applicant process to add processing for the UCAS XML link new reference method, add new fields, and modified disability processing. We have also modified UCAS pages to add new fields. The import reference process has been updated to correct mapping for delayed confirmation processing and added new field. A new process has also been added connecting and mapping applicant data for UCAS link. US Financial Aid 2025-2026 updates. We have delivered new fields, updated DMS scripts and DAT files, as well as other code updates to support direct loan and Pell Grant award processing based on the 2025-2026 award year 5.0C record layout. Updates have been delivered to add new complex tag, CRP number and related changes. ATP related modifications for updated valid date ranges for test code 08 Wunderlich Basic Skills Test WBST and 12 Wunderlich Basic Skills Test Spanish, WBST Spanish, and new state codes of Iowa, IA, and California, CA. Report updates for award year 2025-2026 have been delivered for Pell Grant and direct loans. Message class updates, report file layouts, new fields, and updated fields have been delivered to align with the published specifications for 2025-26 award year. The following updates have been delivered for FMNAC. Updated SFP jar file with the timestamp 2025-03-11-17-12 to align with the most recent specifications published by the Department of Education. Ability to calculate federal taxes for the student and or parent for award years 2024-2025 and forward. An updated CS SFP interface Java file version V7.0, 13 March 2025, has been delivered to support this functionality. View FM SAI detail for award years 2024-2025 and forward. The following updates have been delivered for IMINAS. An update to modify the field size specifications to comply with profile 2025-2026 specifications. FM and IM assumption code pages have been separated into different components because of SPS no longer using assumption codes in the SAI calculation. We delivered the outside application feature to provide institutions with a method to calculate an estimated federal methodology FM value for the students that do not submit a FAFSA or profile application. New pages and various people code have been delivered to support the outside application component. The following new pages have been delivered. Outside application. You can view and or update OA data loaded via the file parser CTM process, or manually insert add OA data. You will be able to invoke an online call to the OA calculation from this component. OA test harness. On the CLI tab, you can generate a CLI feature file that can be provided in SR submissions. On the OA harness tab, you can perform a standalone OA calculation that does not update the inst tables. View outside app audit fields. Allows the user to view information on updates performed to the outside application record, such as which user ID, date, time, record and field names, etc. Outside application staging. Allows a user to review a non-editable view of the loaded OA data. Delete OA records. Allows a user to delete existing OA records. An update has also been delivered to the Mass EFC calculation process to support the application type of O, outside application, for award years 2025 and forward. A new file parser context definition and file layout, and constituent transaction management configuration for loading outside application data via the file parser CTM process has been delivered. We have delivered OA-specific constituent staging and transaction management process pages under the Financial Aid File Management Outside Application folder to support moving the OA data from SFA OA Data Stage to OA Data PAA on a per-student basis or via batch. KM Doc ID 308405 6.1 Outside Application can be referenced for an overview of the outside application bugs delivered and the updates to PeopleBooks. We delivered the new college financing plan templates for the undergraduate and graduate student populations with new specifications for age year 2025-2026. We also delivered the needed update to link the college financial plan from the admission fluid tile. With FSA allowing batch ISA correction files from institutions for age year 2026 and 2025, we have removed the block on the ISA corrections outbound process for age year 2025. We have added ISA min and max Pell indicator fields to the following pages: assign awards to student, invoke professional judgment, assign departmental awards, view financial aid status, view mass packaging details, view batch repackaging details. We delivered our annual move to FA history for age year 2022-2023. The following have been moved to the FA history module: correct 2022-2023 ISA records, maintain applications 2022-2023, manage 2022-2023 verification, and the 2022-2023 INES components. Configurable course catalog numbering. We have delivered a new configurable catalog number enhancement that will allow customers to create a new course catalog number format for specific courses. A new course catalog number format setup page has been delivered to allow campuses to establish various alternative course catalog numbering formats to be used on individual course catalog offerings. The standard course catalog number format, STD, has been delivered with this enhancement. This represents the current delivered catalog number field formatting. We've added a new setup section to the Academic Institution Table, Academic Institution 2 tab with the following new fields: use alternative course catalog number format checkbox, default course catalog number format dropdown, allow to be overridden at course offering definition checkbox, and a link to show the details for the format selected. If the Allow to be overridden at course offer definition checkbox is checked on, an individual course offering can have a unique catalog number format. The Show Standard Format Details link will show the user what the format will look like for the selected format. A new people code warning has been added to this component. If a user checks the Use Alternative Course Catalog Number Format checkbox, or changes any of the other fields associated with this new functionality, they'll be warned that they should add a new effective dated row for the academic institution to protect historical data. If the allow to be overridden at course offer definition checkbox is set to on the Academic Institution 2 page, the checkbox on the course offering page will become active. This field will allow the user to change an individual catalog number to another format that they have set up on the Course Catalog Number Format Setup page. That individual course offering can now have a unique catalog number format. The Course Catalog Number Format default value that appears on this course offerings page is the value identified on the Academic Institution 2 page. If the Allow to be overridden at course offer definition checkbox is on and the effective dating syncs up, the new Course Catalog Number Format section will be active on the Course Offerings tab of the Course Catalog component. This is an example of the Course Offerings page default view before updating an individual course. The Show Standard Format Details link informs the user what the current field format is for the Course Catalog Number field. A new PeopleCode warning pop-up has been added to the course offering page. If the Override Course Catalog Number Format checkbox or any format is modified, the pop-up will inform the user they should add a new effective dated row to the course catalog to ensure that the history is not impacted by the changes. After confirming that the new effective dated row has been added, the user can now select one of the new catalog numbering formats that you set up in the previous steps. The user can now edit the catalog number field to reflect the new catalog number format. In this example, it is the common course numbering format shown above. The user can also verify the format by clicking on the Show Common Course Numbering Format Details link. A new pop-up window will display the specified format as well as the exact new catalog number that the user has entered into the catalog number field above. In addition to the new catalog number, the user will also see the preview format display, with the entire subject and new catalog number displayed for review. If changes are made to the course offerings, and class sections have already been scheduled for the current or future terms, it is highly recommended that the course role process is run for those courses that have been updated with new catalog number, so the changes are reflected in the schedule of classes. Before running the course role process, the catalog numbers are out of sync in the schedule of classes. After running the course role process, the catalog numbers are now in sync in the schedule of classes. Edu-API REST Services. Oracle is investing across our student information system products in the development of an emerging global interoperability standard, Edu-API. We are excited to be delivering the first set of capabilities in PeopleSoft Campus Solutions as part of PUM Image 35 release. Edu-API provides modern integration capabilities following the OneEdTech Edu-API interoperability standard using REST and JSON. These capabilities enable institutions to integrate and exchange data with applications in the ecosystem around PeopleSoft Campus Solutions, following a global industry standard for data exchange. Edu-API has the potential to simplify and streamline your institution's ecosystems, reducing maintenance burden and optimizing student experiences. It also provides expedited onboarding for third-party vendor applications that also adopt and certify to Edu-API, promoting innovation with clean, relevant, secured, and standard data across ecosystem applications. This initial release prioritizes common use cases for integrating PeopleSoft Campus Solutions with downstream applications, such as learning management, parking management, and housing management systems. Delivered capabilities in PUM Image 35 enabled the ability to provision persons, class information, program information, academic periods and sessions, such as terms and semesters, organizations, and class enrollments. Student Financial Planning Enhancements. This enhancement is designed to help users troubleshoot issues and discrepancies that might arise when Campus Solutions anticipated aid entries are created from incoming FPOV2 messages from SFP. The Transaction Details page can be accessed from the SFP Message Log Search Results Data tab. The page will now include an Anticipated Aid Details grid. This provides a comprehensive view of the SFP fund data contained in the FPOV2 message, along with mapped item type and term data from Campus Solutions, and allows users to troubleshoot campus solutions' anticipated aid data issues by providing the mapped item type setup data that controls whether an SFP fund would generate an anticipated aid entry, such as whether there is an SF item type configured to create an entry for an estimated award. This tab includes the academic year and disbursement data from SFP, as well as a column for error messages triggered by the validation performed when messages are pulled from SFP to Campus Solutions. This tab provides SFP fund name, amounts, and type. The fund status and fund acceptance status are important, since these attributes can decide whether an anticipated aid entry is created in Campus Solutions. This tab displays SF item type attributes for the item type that was mapped to the SFP award by the pull process. A blank item type value means that the pull process couldn't map the SFP award to a Campus Solutions item type. The Term Data tab supplies the Campus Solutions term data mapped to the SFP fund using the student's institution, academic career, matching on term begin date and end date. Unmatched rows will have no value in these cells. I'll wrap up by including a list of useful resources for Campus Solutions customers. My Oracle Support should be your primary site for official information. The PeopleSoft Information Portal is a go-to site for almost anything related to Campus Solutions. For interacting with Oracle and your peers, the Oracle Community site is ideal and supports the Ideas Lab site, where all enhancement requests are logged and voted upon. If you're a HUG member, then you know the value of that community and its extensive file libraries. Finally, if you're working with a cloud product like Student Financial Planning, you'll want to bookmark Cloud Customer Connection. Thank you for listening to Campus Solutions PyMimage 35 Highlights, and we hope you'll join us again.